And then the second thing is delete your, these are called symbolic lines, because they're not really open, they're just lines that show doors. So these red things are reference frames, which you need to worry about, yeah? But you can see that they've defined a width for this door. I might keep that there actually as well, but all I'm going to do, that's the door, the geometry of the door, the 3D element of the door. So if I go, that's that bit there. You can see that these bits, which are the frames, these extrusions, if I go back to the ground floor, that's what they are. Now if I go to my, I'm going to just disassociate any constraints, like just before that it gives you an error warning, because what it's doing is it's just moving the geometry out. So really, if I do that, all I need to do then is just move this according to where it needs to be. I can set parameters to define how far it comes off the wall, but I'm not going to do that. So this is like the 3D element, right? And now it's just got the frames, but that's just in plan for the 3D stuff. Right, that's what that'll look like now. Obviously there'll be some sort of detailed connection through there, we don't need to worry about that yet. Right, but now I can go back to my plan, and you're just gonna make sure, if you select an element in a family, there's something called visibility settings. And if I select visibility settings, it says that it won't view that element in plan or reflected ceiling plan, which is right, because you only want to see door panels in 3D or elevation. So I'm going to have to do some symbolic lines. So if I go to the annotate tab and then select the symbolic line, I can draw a box around it. I'll do this one more time. And then you don't forget, you'll load that back into your project, right? And then you just place it there. That one is, but I'll give that in a second. Back to the edit family, there it is. There's some symbolic lines there, there's the door panel, load that back in. Remember, always load back in, override the parameters, and that's all you need to show. You don't need to show anything else. As long as you've called that sliding door and the type is correct, and you've got the correct mark associated to it, that's all you need. Again, I think all of the out-of-the-box content's fine. So if you do want to, you know, I know we couldn't find a sliding door, but if there's anything else, before you download it, you can go to these ones, because I think they're very good. Types, the door types